Okay, so this is a reaction taking an acid chloride to an aldehyde. Remember last reaction we talked about taking an acid chloride when we used one of these lithium aluminum hydride reagents, right? Took it all the way to the primary alcohol because that was lithium aluminum hydride. And lithium aluminum hydride will deliver four hydrides, okay? So if we've got something like this lithium tri-tert-butoxyaluminum hydride, okay? It's a mouthful to say, especially on camera. It's only got the one hydride. So it's a hydride source with just one hydride, okay? So it's going to deliver just that one hydride and then stop, okay? Of course, you got to put just one equivalent or whatever in there, you know, so you don't over-hydride it, over-reduce it. But anyway, so let's just erase this and then we'll do the mechanism of it. And again, there's going to be some question as to, you know, where these aluminum, lithium are placed in it. But we'll just do kind of a general hydride delivery, okay? So, put our lone pair electrons. Remember, with the acid chloride, the chloride's a very good leaving group, right? It's very stable on its own. So, the hydride reagent looks like this. And then Li plus, of course, is the counter ion.
You're missing some metal groups.
One more.
Oh, sorry. So you have these tert butoxides, right? Because it's very bulky, you know, also. Okay, so what these will do is help it, you know, react with, you know, these things that are out flapping outside them on the edges of the molecule, on the periphery. So what will happen here is, of course, this hydride is going to be delivered to that carbonyl carbon. So again, I like to draw the arrow through the hydrogen just to show that it's that atom that's being delivered. That's going to be a forward arrow there. So again, we're going from that sp2 to sp3. And then, of course, well, we'll write it. Is anybody okay if I just put that like that? And then we can put our, like that. So you know that this oxygen doesn't like to be like that. So you know it's going to collapse back down here. And then it's got a choice. What is it going to kick off? The chlorine, the hydrogen, or the alkyl group, right? What's the best leaving group? Of course, it's going to be the chlorine. So it's going to come back down, kick that off like that. And so you've got the aldehyde here. You've got, it's actually going to be kind of partially bonded to that aluminum there. So you're going to have to wash that out with water. Okay, so that's where that last step says, wash it out with water. Okay, so when you do that, that's a problem, you know, so. So there is your aldehyde. So you can use these powerful reducing agents, right? This is very powerful reducing agent. These lithium aluminum hydride reducing agents are very powerful, but usually they're so have so many hydrides on them that they just destroy everything, you know? But you can kind of tweak them to where they, you know, don't have that many hydrides. They only have a single hydride to deliver. And, you know, something like this will happen.
So then this reagent right here would be, like last time you said the lithium aluminum hydride is like a bomb, so this one would not be as...
It's not as, exactly. You know, it's not going to, it's going to reduce the most electrophilic thing, right? And that's this thing here in this molecule, right? But it's only got that one hydride. So since lithium aluminum hydride has four hydrides, right? What would it do after it got here? It would reduce it again, you know what I'm saying? And it would go to the primary alcohol, you know, because you have more hydrides.
Okay.
Everybody cool with that? Can we kill it?